you got blood.
Fans, welcome to NWA Pro Wrestling, another action-packed hour. And we've got some good news this week. For the fourth time now, the World Tag Team Champions are the Rock and Roll Express, Robert Gibson, Ricky Morton. Not only that, we're going to be hearing from Jim Crockett Jr. in just a few moments about the Great American Bash, which will be coming up very soon, Johnny Weaver. And we got a lot of champions we're going to be talking to and seeing during this hour.
Well, it's that time of year again. The Bash will start in July and go to a lot of the big major cities all over the world, and I'm sure that Jim Crockett's going to give us a lot of information about it and what he's planning. Champions, yes, the world champions here, the world tag team champions, the United States tag team champions are here. We have a world TV title match, right. And we have a man over here that holds the U.S. heavyweight championship right
Nikita
here.
Nikita Koloff. Yeah, let's talk to the U.S. champion right here, Nikita.
I tell you, last week I find out what Lex Luger is all about. And what I find out is Lex Luger, he is a tough man. You see, I have defended this title against many tough opponents, but Lex Luger has to be the most tough. You see, Lex Luger, I, Nikita Koloff, know what I can do too. I am the champion all my life, Lex Luger. I don't care if it's wrestling. I don't care if it's amateur track and field. I don't care if it's 124 Olympic, Lex Luger. I have been a champion, and I'm going to be a champion. You, Lex Luger, Jatorta! If you, Lex Luger, think Nikita Koloff is going to lay down and die so you can be you as a champion, you're making a big mistake right here.
All right, Nikita Koloff. Now let's go to Tony Schiavone and Jim Crockett Jr.
Thank you very much, Bob Cottle. As you know, Jim Crockett Promotions, a lot of great events during the course of the year. But there's one event, the big event, the Great American Bash. And coming in July, fans, super summertime fun will be coming your way with the Great American Bash. Now, July 1st at the Civic Center in Lakeland, Florida, starts the Great American Bash on tour. Going to such great cities as Landover, Maryland, and the Capitol Center. Richmond, Virginia, Charleston, West Virginia. The Great American Bash on tour in Oklahoma City, Los Angeles, San Francisco, Dallas, Fort Worth, Cincinnati, Baltimore, Philadelphia, just to name a few. And it all ends up the Great American Bash in the Orange Bowl in Miami, Florida. Also, the king of the bash, of course, David Allen Coe, country rock star in concert. The fabulous Freebirds in concert also with their rock reunion. And saw the top stars, the Rock and Roll Express in concert. And, of course, Mr. Jim Crockett and Jimmy, the Great American Bash, July 4th, a very special date for you in Atlanta.
That's correct, Tony. The Great American Bash, July the 4th in Atlanta, Georgia, is a promoter's dream. And I think it'll be the wrestling fans' dream because we have come up with and signed the most unique match in the history of wrestling. It has never been held before. The Great American Bash, July the 4th, Atlanta, Georgia, the Match Beyond.
We'll be hearing more in the weeks to come about the Match Beyond. Next week, of course, more updates on the Great American Bash. Jimmy, thank you very much. Let's go to the ring.
All right, Tony, and in the ring, the man that is really challenging and hot on the trail of that U.S. championship, there he is, the total package. And what a package that is. Something to behold in the ring, Lex Luger, with James J. Dillon right there in the corner with him, and his opponent here, Gene Ligon and Johnny Weaver. This Luger is really something. Look how powerful he is. And Ligon, who is a big man, he just shoves him aside like nothing.
And, of course, what a brutal fight that was gotten into last week with Lex Luger and Nikita Koloff, and neither would back down an inch. They fought clear out of the building, Bob.
That's right. Right on out of the building, and it took about 10 guys, and they couldn't even separate them.
And I believe there's been accusations made by James J. Dillon about the status of that championship, but Nikita's not going to back down from anybody. It'll be another brutal the two of them meet. And Luger, a great athlete. Look at the physique on Luger. There is that power slam, and he's signaling for that backbreaker. Will he hoist him up in the backbreaker right here? Luger, a very strong individual, just picks Ligon up like it was nothing. Got him up in that backbreaker. We got a victor right here, Bob.
We've never seen anybody get out of that hole. Luger gets him on the shoulders in the backbreaker. It's curtains, and it was curtains right there for Gene Ligon. Let's watch it right here again, fans, in slow motion. Ligon's going to come off of the ropes. Luger's going to get him hard to the mat with that power slam, and this is the beginning of the end, Johnny.
And from there was a signal for the backbreaker, and a powerfully built individual, Lex Luger, hoisted Gene Ligon on his shoulders right here as if he was weighing nothing, and a victory for Lex Luger.
Fans, here it is, Lex Luger, the total package, and the fans saw again some of the film of you and Nikita right out of the arena you wrestled.
The waiting is over, Nikita Koloff. My patience is gone. I had to ring in your doorbell many a time to finally get you to answer, and now you've answered. Nikita Koloff, next time I come ringing, I'm not going to ring, I'm not going to knock, I'm going to kick your front door right off the hinges. I'm taking what's mine, and that's a U.S. heavyweight title.
Lex Luger fans, and we'll be right back after this.
The NWA, the Philadelphia Civic Center, Saturday, June 27th. The bell time is 8:30. Kendall Windham will take on Vladimir Petrov. Barry Windham against Ivan Koloff for the World Tag Team title. Two out of three falls. New champions, the Rock and Roll Express, will defend against the Midnight Express with Jim Cornette. For the U.S. heavyweight title, Nikita Koloff will defend against Lex Luger. A one-fall death match, Dusty Rhodes with Magnum T.A. will take on Tully Blanchard with Dark Journey. And for the world title, no disqualification, Nature Boy Ric Flair will defend against Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin with Precious in Philadelphia. Let's bring in Tully Blanchard and Dark Journey. A one-fall death match against Dusty Rhodes, who will have Magnum T.A. in his corner in Philadelphia.
You know, Tony Schiavone, you got to think back about how exciting Philadelphia is in the Civic Center when the National Wrestling Alliance is in town, especially when the horsemen are in town. And speaking most in particularly about myself, when I bring Dark Journey down that aisle and everybody starts swooning in their seats. And then you think about Big Dust, the Saturday night hero, as he likes to call himself, is going to come down the aisle with the gimp Magnum T.A. No matter how great he used to be in the past, we're talking today, 1987. He doesn't have what it takes, but if he wants to come down here and get the bird's eye view, that's fine too, because one fall death match, Big Dust, no rules, and you know, that's when I excel, because you've been there before.
The new breed and two young men that have really created quite a stir, Chris Champion and Sean Royal. And Johnny, they bring some different moves and something different, I think, to professional wrestling.
And what the Rock and Roll, the World Tag Team Champions, is going to put a new light on the picture, too, because the new breed have been breathing down the Rock and Roll neck, and along with Lasertron and the Boogie Woogie Man, Jimmy Valiant. Now, the new breed says that the days of rock and roll are over, that Boogie Woogie Jimmy Valiant is gone into rock and roll.
All right, fans, right now, let's go to Tony Schiavone, who has Jimmy Garvin there with him. Tony? Thank you very much, Bob Cotto. Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin, along with his lady Precious. And Jimmy, I know, among other things on your mind, the Nature Boy Ric Flair.
There's a lot of things on my mind, Tony Schiavone, and Ric Flair is one of them. The fact is this, though, before I say anything, I'd like to tell everybody to get ready, tighten those seatbelts on that couch or that favorite chair, because you're getting ready to see the greatest in professional wrestling action. And I'd like to congratulate the Rock and Roll, as you can hear the people chanting, Rock and Roll, to the new World Tag Team Champion, and that's okay with me and Squeeze. Now, the fact is this, everybody knows the Great American Bashes are right around the corner. We're getting ready for a bust-out good time, a heck of a summer. And Ric Flair, it's just a matter of time, Pally, because I know you're wounded. And as far as the rest of the Four Horsemen go, it's just a matter of time for all of you. Your days are numbered, Pally. If it's not me, it's going to be Hands of Stone, the American Dream, Barry Windham. Oh, there's a list, many, many more. Now, Squeeze, guess what? There's so much action going on, my lips are getting dry, and I think I'm going to have a kiss.
Okay, Bob, Johnny.
Well, Johnny, you notice who's still right there with him. Precious, right with Jimmy Garvin.
All right at his side, and the only thing that might leave in that situation is a belt from the round of the World Heavyweight Champion, Ric Flair. And what an exciting team in the ring, this new breed with some great moves. You know, the Rock and Roll Express being the World Tag Team Champions now have had a great asset on their side all the time of speed and quickness, Bob. But right here, the new breed, they got a lot of speed and quickness and desire and youth on their side. Started the same credentials that the Rock and Roll Express originally came here with.
And they got good size, too, to go with that. Plus the fact that, Johnny, they bring a new dimension in some of the moves that they have.
And they fly through the air with drop kicks and some great aerial maneuvers that really softens up their opponent. And there's a big body slam right now on Mike Force. And to the top turnbuckle goes Chris Champion. Look at this. Look at this maneuver. He's backwards. He turned around in midair. Cross body block. And we got a victory.
Cross body block over the top rope. The winners are the new breed. Fans, you heard the big news at the beginning of the program. New World Tag Team Champions. For the fourth time now, the Rock and Roll Express. What about it, Johnny?
And we got some footage to show you that where the match that they won the belts back from Rick Rude, the Raging Bull, and the Rock and Roll Express. Here it comes.
All right, and fans, right now, let's watch some of the action as we pick it up here. Johnny, this match has already been going on for some time. All four of the wrestlers have really taken a lot of punishment. And at this point, they look like they've got Robert Gibson, the Bull, has Gibson down on the mat, and looks like he may have Robert in some trouble.
Well, we're certainly happy to be able to bring this match to the wrestling fans of NWA Pro Wrestling, because I know this is a match that everybody's wanting to see. The world champions at this point, right, we're watching the match, Raging Bull and Rick Rude, and of course the Rock and Roll Express. And Bob, as you alluded to earlier, they are a long time in this match. It's probably at the 30-minute mark right now. It's been rough and tough on both teams, and Robert's in a lot of trouble at the hands of the Raging Bull at the present time.
Well, he tried to make a tag. The Bull got him from behind, drug him back out toward the center of the ring, and then went with that suplex, and here he's got a counter. Oh, and the Bull thought he had him. What? You could tell by the way the Bull was looking back at the referee, giving that count. He was counting him off himself. Paul Jones, while looks concerned, he does look too worried at this point, Johnny.
Well, he knows that it's been a patented maneuvers of the Raging Bull for a long, long time. First comes that suplex that softens him up. Very soon or shortly after that, he's going to come with a flying burrito. A flying burrito usually puts him away, Bob.
Well, these youngsters, Ricky Morton, Robert Gibson, they have looked forward to this match. They've been wanting it for a long, long time. It's the primary thing they've had on their mind for months now.
There's a lot of speed and quickness on both teams here. Both teams that have a lot of experience as being the world champions, and I'm sure that Jones and the Bull and Rude want to hang on to that belt as bad as the Rock and Roll wants it back. And look at them really straining into the corner. Let's see if a tag can be made. Oh, he did tag him. He did tag it. Here he is, Ricky Morton in the ring, referee cutting him off, Bob.
And he made the tag. We saw it on the tape. The referee receiving and back out of the ring. And Rhodes now with Gibson in the corner. And Gibson, he looks almost out on his feet.
Gibson's in a lot of trouble and really crashes into that turnbuckle. Rhodes, a great specimen of a man with a physique that just won't quit. He pounds away on Robert Gibson. Robert is getting in more trouble and more trouble. Oh, but he has enough left arm to pick him up. Reverse atomic drop. Both men are down. They need a tag. Both of them need a tag. Robert desperately needs the tag.
Robert looking around at Rick, and he's a long way from that corner. He saw just how far he had to go.
Rick Rude trying to tag the ball. And there's a tag made to Ricky Martin. This time he's allowed to stay in the ring. Right and left to the head of the raging bull.
The bull off the rope for the elbow. Goes after Rude, who is outside now. Morton, who is fresh, had gotten a rest outside of the ring while Robert was in.
Flying head scissors. Reverses back and brings him over. He's got him. Just a two count there, Bob.
Al Rude came in also to give Bull the save at that point. Now here we got all four men in the ring. There goes Ricky out of the ring, through the rope, down on the floor.
And they double team on Robert in the ring. Robert has already been in a bad situation. Here's Ricky from the outside. Shoulder block on the Bull. From the outside, he hooks him. What a match. What a match. Wow, what a match. Ricky Martin from the outside. Look at Paul.
And fans now, for the fourth time, the World Tag Team Champions, welcome one half of the Rock and Roll Express. Here is Ricky Morton.
I tell everybody that they stood behind us 100% by the fullest summer came. We'll be four times NWA World Tag Team Champions. And you know, I heard Mr. Crockett talking earlier about the bashes coming up. Remember one thing, Rock and Roll will be there, and we will be there as world champions, baby, because that's what it's all about. You see, Robert's so excited, he's still out celebrating, Bob. And Rock and Roll, remember, is here forever, the fourth time NWA World Tag Team Champions. Thank you, Bob. I'd like to thank everybody for standing behind the Rock and Roll Express. We said we're going to do it, and you made us do it, because when we're there, and you're standing there at Rock and Roll, baby, and got it. You hear what I'm talking about, Bob? It is here, baby, at Rock and Roll. Woo! It's here to stay. We'll be standing. Thank you.
All right, fans, there it is, Ricky Morton.
The one and only American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. I know the Great American Bash brings back memories for you that night in Greensboro, winning the world title once again.
What is the hottest time of the year? I feel so good in that. Out here right before we come on, I found these book of matches in Tony's coat here, say, the Hemsley Palace in New York City. We know about that night. Dusty Rhodes feels so good. Tully Blanchard belongs to me. The money belongs to me. Maggie taking care of business with the money. Let me tell you something, baby. Let me tell you something good. You know, on a Friday night, let's say the Hemsley Palace. Let's say the place where the Nature Boy hangs out. Let's say the limousines. You know what I mean? Always late on a Friday night, I get just a little bit whiskey bit and glory bound. You know what I mean? And I start thinking about the Great American Bash. Dusty Rhodes being World's Heavyweight Champion for the third time. I start feeling good because Friday night is the night of heroes. And Saturday night, I am the champion of legendary Saturday night. So let the good times roll. Rock and Roll Express, full-time World's Tag Team Champion. Made me feel good inside. Made me want to dance
twist his shirt and do a double backflip. I'm beside myself. And when I'm beside myself, that's about 600 pounds. 3 and 3, you understand? So Tully Blanchard, you got me in a good mood tonight. And Doc Journey asked Tully Blanchard, the last woman that he had with him, what happened to her, you understand? After making a lady out of her like I did. You know what I mean, Doc Journey? Woo, I love brown sugar too, baby.
The American dream, Dusty Rhodes. Fans, there's only one. And we'll be right back. Don't you dare go away. Right here on NWA Pro Wrestling.
Let's stop BSing the people in this country. Ric Flair, let's stop BSing the people in this country. Lex Luger, Arn Anderson, Jay Dillon, let's stop talking about it.
You might end up with your foot in your mouth. You can't judge an apple by looking at a tree. You can't judge a honey by looking at the bee. You can't judge a daughter by looking at the mother. You can't judge it by looking at the brother. Come on, baby.
Rock and Roll Express, enjoy your new belts real good, because these are the men who are going to take them away from you. Beautiful Bobby and Sweet Stan, the Midnight Express.
Along with Jim Cornette. The opponents in this match, Ricky Nelson, John Savage, and Johnny Weaver. One thing I think Jim Cornette said is true. I definitely believe that the Midnight Express and Rock and Roll are on a collision course. Those two expresses are bound to collide head on.
Now, in the past, the Midnight Express, on one occasion, took the belts away from the Rock and Roll Express when they were world champions before, and it was Jim Cornette behind him that Midnight Express got those world titles.
And here is Jim Cornette right here with us.
Stick that microphone up here, Bob Caudle. Let me tell you something. While the greatest tag team in wrestling, the U.S. Tag Team Champions, are going about their business as only they can, you were exactly right, Johnny Weaver. Are you any relation to Doodles Weaver, by the way? You were exactly right. The Midnight Express are the ones who took the title from the Rock and Roll Express before. And, brother, we're going to do it again, because, you see, the Rock and Roll Express, every time they've lost those titles, they've always got them back. Every team that's got something on them, they've always got revenge, except against the Midnight Express. We are the only team in wrestling that they have not been able to successfully put down, that they have not been able to successfully take out, that they have not been able to get off their back and get rid of. We've been a thorn in their side. And, brother, we're going to be a thorn in their side on this one, too. We're going to take those world tag team belts away from them and show everybody. You know, the Rock and Roll, they got everybody bluffed. They think all the Rock and Roll can do is win matches. That all that they can do is sing their songs and win the World Tag Team Championship, and everything's going to be fine. They got all the teeny boppers bluffed. They got everybody bluffed. But the fact is that we are the ones that can take the Rock and Roll Express. We, and only we, the real Express in wrestling, the Midnight Express. Johnny, what are you chuckling about?
Hey, you're doing all the talking, but your two guys are the ones that are going to have to deliver, and they're going to be up. Well, you're the world champions, the top, the cream of the crop, the class.
The class, yeah, they got a lot of the class. Oh, whoa, I'm going to tell you that right now. The fact is, Bob Carter,
Cornette, he had to go over and talk to Sweet Stan about that. Got you a little riled there, didn't it? A little worried for a moment.
I was just giving my man a little word of advice. The fact of the matter is, Bob Caudle, as far as the Rock and Roll Express goes, they are destined to always lose their titles to the Midnight Express. They are destined. destined to always be beaten by the Midnight Express. They are destined, it is their fate, to always be humiliated by the Midnight Express. We're the one fungus that they can't wipe off that shower. We are the one growth that they can't cut out. We are the one thing that they cannot stop. Every other team, look what they've done. Every time they've lost belts, they've regained them. Every time they've suffered a loss, they have come back and they've avenged that loss. But the Midnight Express, they have never been able to put down and never will.
Well, they got a double team going right now on Rick Nelson, Johnny. Gorgeous Bobby had him on the mat.
Look at the form. The Rock and Roll Express can wrestle. So can the Midnight Express. The Rock and Roll Express got speed. The Midnight Express are quicker. The Rock and Roll Express got technique. They got teamwork. Man, these guys are born to be a tag team. In short, look at that Rick Nelson right there. He got one move on the Midnight Express. The Rock and Roll have had a few moves on us too, but we always come back. And that's something that the Rock and Roll Express can't stomach, and that's something that all our teeny bopper fans can't stomach, because that's the fact. We're the best, we're the real Express, and they're only holding our belts. It's so apropos that finally the belts come back to the Rock and Roll so that we can take them away from the people who stole them from us in the first place.
Look at Bobby, reaching out that hand. He's been wondering, what's he doing there, Jim? He's wanting to shake with Sammy.
He's trying to demonstrate that we're also very good sports. We are sportsmen above all, first and foremost. We're fair and we're square kind of guys, except when you get us riled. And look at beautiful Bobby going up to the top rope.
You call this sportsmanship, huh?
Yeah, I sure do. If you could do that, Bob Caudle, you'd be doing it too. Bob Caudle, because that would mean that you're a great athlete, just like beautiful Bobby is. And John Savage don't know where he is, makes the tag to Rick Nelson, and now you see, Rick Nelson thinks he's got everybody buffaloed too. Well, Sweet Stan's gonna teach him a thing or two, right like he did there, flat on his back, brother. And that's the same way that Ricky Morton and Robert Gibson are gonna be when we get finished with them. The heart of rock and roll still beating. Rock and roll's here to stay. Well, the Midnight Express ain't going nowhere either, brother. I guarantee you that. We ain't going nowhere except straight to the top. We're now the U.S. Tag Team Champions, and before it's over, we're going to be the World Tag Team Champions, too.
They had Nelson with a backbreaker. Now they got him double-teamed.
Oh,
on the face, Johnny. What about that one?
And Ricky Nelson's going to look like he's been chasing parked cars right about now.
Oh, there's the United States Tag Team Champions, the Midnight Express, Sweet Stan, beautiful Bobby. Of course, Cornette on the outside. What a maneuver.
Boy, this is a devastating ending right here. The maneuver they put on Rick Nelson, they double-team him, and it's face first to the mat.
They stand him straight up in the air on their shoulders and right down, drive him right into the mat.
The United States Tag Team Champions are the winners.
New maneuvers from the U.S. Tag Team Champion every time we see them. And that's why they remain the U.S. Tag Team Champions, the Midnight Express.
The NWA at the Philadelphia Civic Center, Saturday, June 27th. The bell time is 8:30 in Philadelphia. On the card, you'll see Kendall Windham as he goes up against Vladimir Petrov. Barry Windham will take on the Russian Bear, Ivan Koloff. A match for the NWA World Tag Team title, 2 out of 3 falls. The new champions, the Rock and Roll Express, will defend against the U.S. Tag Team Champions, the Midnight Express with Jim Cornette. For the U.S. Heavyweight title, Nikita Koloff will defend against Lex Luger. A one-fall death match, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, with Magnum T.A. in his corner, will take on Tully Blanchard along with Dark Journey. And for the NWA World Heavyweight title, no disqualification, the champion, Nature Boy Ric Flair, will defend against gorgeous Jimmy Garvin with Precious at the Philadelphia Civic Center, the NWA. Saturday, June 27th, the bell time is 8:30. The best in wrestling, the NWA, returns to Philadelphia. As we said, 2 out of 3 falls for the World Tag Team title in Philadelphia. The Rock and Roll Express will defend against the Midnight Express. Here's Robert Gibson.
You know, Tony, last time we was in Philadelphia, we had a 2 out of 3 fall. The only thing different is now we are the champions. Last time we was the challengers. Midnight Express, Jim Cornette, you remember what happened last time in Philadelphia. We beat your Midnight Express not once but twice right there in the Philadelphia Civic Center. So let me tell you something, guys. You better gear up. Now hold on tight, baby, because like we said before the summer was over, Tony, we would be the new NWA World Tag Team Champions. And you can see, we have done that. So, guys, gear up, baby. It's been a long time since we've been back to Philadelphia. The fans there love us. We love them. So, guys, like I said, gear up, hold on tight, baby, because my brother and I, we get there, Tony, we'll do one thing. We're going to explode like dynamite right there in Philadelphia.
All right, back at ringside, fans in the ring are the Russians. Big Vladimir Petrov, Ivan Koloff, and Paul Jones in the corner with them. Across the way, we've got Rocky King and Tommy Angel, and the crowd in the arena with a champ, USA, USA. Johnny, we announced last week that Paul Jones was given permission by the NWA to choose anybody he wanted to team with the Raging Bull, and he chose Ivan Koloff or Vladimir Petrov.
Well, we're going to get to see Ivan and Vladimir right here in the ring. We've got Paul Jones climbing down here. Maybe we can get a word with Paul.
Jones.
I've got something to say. How in the world can the fans and Rock and Roll Express get out here, pat themselves on the back, congratulate themselves for winning the belt? Ravisher Rick Rude was injured, and the Raging Bull almost beat both of them by himself. And that is a problem. And let me tell you something. Rock and Roll, you caught us with our pants.
Comes Rocky King right down at Paul Jones, and Jones with a
shooter. But let me tell you something. I'm regrouping. The bashes are coming up. I'm going to be ready. You're looking at the two Russians in there. They're going to be ready with me. The Raging Bull, the Barbarian's coming back. So don't sell number one Paul Jones shirt. When the bashes get here, I'll be ready. And let me tell you something. I made a mistake. But you learn by your mistakes, and when you get knocked down, you get up, you dust yourself off, and you come back even stronger.
Yeah, there you heard it from Paul Jones. And Johnny, I think Paul Jones, he's a very sly, devious, and an extremely shrewd individual. Just when you think you got him down and you got him beaten, Paul Jones always seems to come back.
Extremely shrewd is exactly right, because he's chosen two of the best conditioned athletes in the world, and of course Ivan Koloff, the big Russian bear on the outside right now, has been tag team champions on several occasions. He knows what it is. He's been through the battles, and he's got a lot of experience.
He's got a chain right now around the neck of Tommy Angel, as Angel's in the corner.
And of course, big Vladimir, 300 plus pounds, Barbarian. Nobody knows what he's going to do. So it's going to be a tough road for the Rock and Roll Express, especially when they meet the camp of Paul Jones.
Koloff over the top rope, right down across the back of Angel as he was held by Petrov. Petrov, very huge, very big, extremely strong individual.
We know that Jones, to put together the team of Rude and Bull, went to spend a lot of money, big bucks, and got two of the greatest in the world to put them together. Now he's got down to the Bull, but he's got some great choices in there. Ivan, many, many times the World Tag Team Champion. He knows what that's all about. And, of course, in superior condition. Out here is now coming in the ring, Vladimir, over 300 pounds. And I think Jones stands in pretty good position yet. Looking at the Great American Bashes on their way in July.
I agree with you, Johnny, because one thing that Paul Jones has done, just think of the experience now that he's had in his corner with Ivan.
And Koloff. He's getting ready for that Russian sickle, and boy, when Vladimir gives you one, look at those biceps and those arms. You really get hit with a Russian sickle.
He turned the lights out on Angel with that sickle, hard to the mat, and he's still flat on his back. And we can watch the end right here again in slow motion, fans, as Angel is going to come off of the ropes. When he gets up, watch Vladimir. He's poised and ready right here.
And he's got that big arm ready to tear the head off of Tommy Angel. And right there, right on the button, the Russian sickle. The winners of the match, Vladimir Petrov and Ivan Koloff. Of course, they're accompanied by Paul Jones.
And fans, will be right back. We'll have more after we take time out for this message.
Tell you what, when this man walked up here, everybody standing up, chanting, champ, champ, this is the man, the world champion, Ric Flair.
Here we go again. It's going to be a hot summer. The Great American Bash on Tour, Jim Crockett Promotion, and the Four Horsemen, woo, that's what's cooking at the Great American Bash. And when I talk about the Four Horsemen, we're talking about long limousine. We're talking about styler profiling. We're talking about fast jet airplanes. And we're talking about even faster women. But most of all, we're talking about the competition that makes the four greatest wrestlers in the world go round and round. And yes, Big Dust, I remember number 13 last year. You walked that aisle and you beat the champ. But my friend, it's a new year. And the world champion is bigger
and better than ever before. Nikita Koloff, you gotta be hearing footsteps, buddy, because that 6'5" giant, that friend of mine, Lex Luger, doesn't like walking in the Marriott and higher regencies without that U.S. belt. The girls all say, "Woo, Lex, you're the package. Please bring us that belt." And now we got new World Tag Team Champions, the Rock and Roll Express. My hat's off to you, boys. And my hat's off to all those little teeny boppers and their training bras that think you're a big deal. But what are you going to tell them a month from now when two of the horsemen, maybe myself and Luger, maybe Tully and I, but I'll guarantee you, two of the four of us are going to have those world belts. Luger's going to have the U.S. Championship, and Ric Flair, woo, in all his magnificence, is going to be the world champion. Big Dust, Nikita, Garvin, and Precious, don't think for a minute that I'm going to make it the rest of the summer without you on my arm. You belong with Space Mountain. Woo!
Okay, let's go to the ring, fans.
And in the ring, Tony, we're ready with our World Television title match. As the champion, Tully Blanchard, in the corner with his private secretary, Dark Journey, as he hands her that championship belt. And the opponent, he's a big one. Across the way is Todd Champion. And this should be an exciting match. I think Tully Blanchard is really going to have to go all out this match. One fall, 10-minute time limit. And Tully's $10,000 is going to be at stake during this match. But this champion is a big, tough individual, Johnny.
About 270 pounds out of Los Angeles. Great shot of Dark Journey. She looks a little undecided outside, too, as her man puts the title on the line. 10-minute time limit as James J. Dillon and Tully Blanchard are once again dictating the rules that surround this World Television belt.
The man who has held a World Television Championship longer than any other man, Tully Blanchard. He's a master at using the clock. He uses the time in every match to his advantage.
And there must be a reason that James J. Dillon and Tully Blanchard have designated 10 minutes in this match. And we have, over with Tony Schiavone, J.J. Dillon. Maybe we'll find out.
Okay, thank you very much, Johnny Weaver. James J. Dillon, leader of the Four Horsemen, watching your World TV champion in the ring.
Tony, what you're looking at is the sole product of the most successful conglomerate in all of professional sports. Of course, referring to Tully Blanchard Enterprises, the sole product I refer to is the World Television Champion, Mr. Tully Blanchard, with his traveling personal secretary, Dark Journey, by his side. The man who will bank $100,000 of the common people's money. The man who will successfully defend the World Television title throughout the Great American Bash on tour across this great land throughout the summer. The man who, with Arn Anderson, is already a viable challenge for the World Tag Team Champions, now held by the Rock and Roll Express. And with the world champion, Ric Flair, by his side, with the awesome total package, Lex Luger, destined to be the next U.S. champion, by his side, the unit, the Four Horsemen. They are professional wrestling. They are what makes wrestling happen, and they will dominate the Great American Bash. This is the symbol of success.
Okay, back to the ring.
All right, and fans, you heard it right there from the lips of James J. Dillon, the Four Horsemen. They're going to the Great American Bash. Not only that, he says that Tully Blanchard is very definitely going to walk away with $100,000, $50,000 of the common people's money.
That remains to be seen, but the Four Horsemen generally dominate everything they do, Bob. And right here, right now, Todd Champion has been the dominating force in this match. Tully Blanchard complaining to the referee about something. Todd a little bewildered, but he doesn't run in there and make a mistake.
Well, Blanchard has got to be very leery right here, and he's going to be $10,000 short as Todd Champion can take it right away from him in a twinkle of the eye.
And the big youngster knows that this is a great opportunity for him, a television title match on nationwide TV here against Tully Blanchard.
Good move on the part of Blanchard. He hooked that leg and shoved Champion to the mat, and boy, that got him mad.
Yes.
He riled up the big one.
But right here now, Blanchard playing his mind game. Now the youngster may not be set for these tactics. And he, his confidence will be built up. Tully knows exactly what he's doing. That's why he's bailing out of that ring. Has a conversation with Dark Journey. The clock's ticking all the time. And he really getting Todd Champion irritated. Irritated to a point he may rush in and make a fatal mistake.
As we mentioned, he's a master using the clock always to his advantage. And fans, I hope you were with us earlier for the big announcement of the new World Tag Team Champions, the Rock and Roll Express, Ricky Morton, Robert Gibson. For the fourth time now, they're the World Tag Team Champions.
Also, the announcement from Jim Crockett about the match beyond, Bob, and we're going to have to remain in next week to find out what this is all about, but I'm sure it's going to be a great event. The match beyond to be held in Atlanta as a part of the Great American Bash. We'll get more news on that as the weeks continue. The Great American Bash is getting ready for July.
That's right, July fast approaching. So the Great American Bash just around the corner now. Champion with a good leg takedown as Blanchard came off of the ropes.
Excellent maneuver by Big Todd. Champion, of course, he's 270, but he sure moves around that ring with a lot of quickness. I think Tully Blanchard is finding that out, and also all that weight laying on Tully is going to wear him down a little bit. Maybe he won't be able to use those tactics of backpedaling, running away. He tried to get out of the ring right there. The champion, big and strong, wouldn't let him escape. And now Blanchard taking the blunt of the punishment as Todd drags him right back to the center of the ring and continues with the advantage.
Blanchard now backpedaling back to the ropes, trying to grab him again to get out of the ring. And that time, he got underneath the rope as the referee starts to count and tells Todd Champion to break. Now Blanchard's outside. That's where he tried to go earlier. Dark Journey escorting him around the ring.
Blanchard trying to walk off the effects of that leg lock took out of his legs here. Of course, not only was he taking something out of the legs, it was taking a lot out of the body because Todd Champion had that whole 270 pounds laying on Tully Blanchard. Tully does seem to be maneuvering a lot slower than he does in most of his title matches. But he's going to open up the attack now.
He's been very deliberate so far. Now with Champion against the ropes, he goes to work.
Champion fires right back. They trade up Tully with the advantage, however. Reversal by Champion. Football tackle. Knocks down a Champion. Tully again trying to escape. Todd Champion dragging him back. Blanchard in trouble. His knees buckled by that forearm by Todd Champion.
Up for the power slam. Very groggy World Television Champion right now getting to his feet.
Todd with another strong forearm off the rope. Late elbow, missed an elbow drop. He missed an elbow drop, a little over anxious. Didn't have as much taken out of Blanchard as he's figured. Tully now steps in.
Gives him the opportunity. There it is.
He executed it. 270 pounds. He brought over that slingshot suplex. And there's the winner. Tully Blanchard, the World TV Champion, and still the World TV Champion.
Now, one mistake by Todd Champion did it. Let's watch the end again in slow motion, fans. Champion had him going till he made that mistake with the elbow drop, and this set up the slingshot right here.
And Blanchard hoists Todd Champion in the air. Off the ropes, the slingshot effect. Back and down on the mat goes Big Todd Champion. Tully Blanchard successfully defends the TV title one more time. The winner, Tully Blanchard.
All right, fans, here he is, still the World Television Champion, Tully Blanchard. Boy, I tell you, though, the big dust is waiting on you, and you know that. $100,000.
Bob Cuddle, do you know what it means to be able to come out here on national television each and every week with this? This is $500,000 a year in income, okay? Besides all the other extra monies and the fringe benefits. Todd Champion right here. Great big guy, ex-pro football player, big time athlete, was beside himself tonight because he had a shot at glory on a Saturday glory night. God, I've heard that somewhere before.
Yeah.
But Big Dust, you get beside yourself maybe two times, three times, three times, three, and you set foot in a Greensboro Coliseum. Because Big Dust If I was to listen to you, I wouldn't come. But Dark Journey, myself, Flair, Luger, and JJ are gonna pull up in that big long limousine, horseman style. And when we leave with the $100,000 and you with your head down and Magnum living out, that's all that needs to be said, Big Dust.
Then that's gonna wrap it up for this week. We'll see you next week. And until then, so long for now.